Hello everybody, my name is Jagiero, and welcome back to episode 58 of Jagiland. On the last episode, I worked on a concept for a new project, Sludgegulp Village, and we built this little house structure, and then basically threw slime at it, is the essential concept for most of the places around here, essentially. I love the idea of just being able to create these simple structures and then, like I said, just throw slime and sludge and snot and goop. It's going to be great. Everything's going to look like really disgusting. It's going to be amazing. It's such a fun thing to play around with. So I'm looking really looking forward to working more in this area. Okay, so since the last episode, I've only really worked on two little small concepts, and one of them is for the ground. So we're going to go with this mix of just regular grass blocks, podzol, and leaves. And, you know, I'll have little water patches and lily pads everywhere, that kind of thing. I don't think I'm going to be using the coarse dirt. I don't think that works very well. I think it stands out too much. Over here, I think the path blocks are going to work quite well for this area. So I think we'll be using them for the sort of pathways. But, a lot of the pathways will be actually, you know, on raised platforms connecting all these structures together, so maybe it won't be used a lot. So maybe I'll just use a random decoration block, why not? Again, the coaster stands out too much, so I won't be using that. Maybe I'll be able to use some of the stained clay blocks. Maybe they'll be useful for me. I don't think the brown one, I think it's going to be too dark. Maybe the darker green one, though, perhaps. Over here, I just have a concept for some small, like fungal growths, I guess, like little mini shrooms. I wasn't so sure about the end rods because of the little purple bit, but I think, you know, when you're stood far enough away, they will work. Plus, they will add a bit of lighting to the place. And obviously, glowstone works very well for this area because you can hide it underneath the slime blocks. I think that works pretty well. This one, not so much because you can see through this too much, so I don't like that. But as you can see, I just added one on top of the house, and yeah, I think if we use this in the right way, it could work pretty well. And over here, as you saw at the beginning of the episode, I have done a small concept for a snot shroom. Yes, it's mushroom infested by the sludge, and it's all now just like diseased, and it's all taking over it, and it's all dripping down, and that kind of thing. I like the idea of this. You are having a bad time, sir. I really like the idea of doing these mushrooms everywhere. I'm a little concerned that the green may take over the place, so I've left in the red mushroom blocks. I may question this decision later on, but for now, I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it. Okay, so today, though, we are going to be doing two things. Number one, we are going to be building a section of the wall. Not all of it, just a small section, probably, because it's going to be a big project to do all the way around, and I want it to be seen from spawn, so it's going to be along that edge. And over here, over this area, I've been doing just a bit of terraforming work. Well, I say terraforming work, I've basically been doing a big large flat plot of land with loads of dirt everywhere. This is just so that I had a more of a solid base to do the wall along, which you know, I think it's just a much better place to start, and it's going to creep all the way along around that way, around that corner, and go along all the way over there. I've terraformed this hill over here so that it makes more sense for the lumber barges to travel along this way, and then they are free to go along a river that way. So maybe we can do, you know, one over there and then a couple coming this way, perhaps. Maybe that would make some sense. And also, I believe Alex, it's always Alex, that's in a good way, definitely a good way, by the way. He suggested, I think it was him anyway, to use sludge barges. So like, if I have like rivers flowing around the village, and then they have like barges transporting sludge to different places, that sounds awesome. Was it Alex? Or was it I'm a Boat? Which is still an awesome name, by the way. I can't remember, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I fail. Professional YouTuber. Oh, nighttime. Okay. Okay, yes. And the second thing we're going to be doing today is a large lake. Lake Squelchamere. Cool name, right? Okay, so the name is from, there's a place in the northwest of England called Cumbria, and they have a famous lake called Lake Windermere. Lake Squelchamere. Don't question. Just accept it. Okay? Alright guys, so I'm going to first off grab a load of blocks and start building the wall along that sort of section, and I'm going to talk to you guys about something I've been thinking about recently. Alright guys, so there's a little something that has been on my mind recently. I've always maintained that I don't do this series for the numbers, you know, I do keep an eye on how many views I get and how many subscribers I have, but I don't necessarily do it for that. I do this because I enjoy doing it. I enjoy showing off different things that I've built. I mostly enjoy the editing process. I enjoy learning about it. I don't necessarily enjoy doing it because it's a bit of a chore, especially with Sony Vegas, which I tweet about every week how much I hate it, but I'm too scared to learn anything new. Essentially, plus I don't have the time. That's my excuse. Anyway, I'm just scared. And, yeah. So, I don't necessarily do this for the numbers, but I have noticed recently that the numbers are dwindling, or at least they're not growing. They're not necessarily dwindling, but they're not growing. As of this moment, I think I have 253 subscribers. In the last few weeks, I've gained about 4. That's quite low considering how many I was gaining when I first started doing YouTube. And one reason for that is definitely because I am no longer allowed to mention my YouTube on the Minecraft Reddit. Like I was essentially posting imager galleries of screenshots of the builds that I've been doing, having a link to my YouTube on those galleries and then posting that on the Minecraft Reddit. And I definitely like gained subscribers from that. I wouldn't say like I was directly advertising my channel. More like indirectly, I guess. But I've been warned several times about doing it, and the Minecraft moderators I have found are quite unreasonable, quite unfriendly, and they basically won't listen to me when I say that, for instance, if I post a screenshot gallery of a build and I link a video, the video is about that build. You know, it actually shows me building the build. So it's directly related to it. And that is part of the rules. You know, you're not allowed to post videos that aren't directly related, blah, 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 blah. It is directly related. They don't listen to that. They don't care. They're not interested in having me post my YouTube at all. The last gallery that I posted didn't mention my YouTube because I was scared of the ban, and they deleted it because it had a link to another gallery that had a YouTube link in it, like Galleryception, which makes me sad. I linked my Twitter in the new one, and I just hope they just allow me to link my Twitter. Like, surely that's okay, please. Yeah, but like I said, I found them to be very unreasonable people. And just going off on a little bit of a tangent here, Hypixel recently tweeted that he also finds them very unreasonable and very unfriendly. And that's scary because Hypixel is a big thing. And it's scary because Mojang read the Reddit, the Minecraft Reddit. They 100% do because they take a lot of suggestions from there. Plus also And there's also like public opinion from there. They gauge it on the Minecraft Reddit as well. And also, I believe at the minute there is a competition where you can post your screenshots of the new snapshot blocks, and you can get your pictures put in the preview for the latest snapshot. So like that's a big thing. Like you can get your pictures shown with the game. So you know, they definitely participate in the Minecraft Reddit. So to have these moderators pick and choose who they want to ban on unreasonable grounds, to me, is just, that's a very scary thing. And like I said, Hypixel agrees with me. So there, must be right. So that's one reason why my subscribers are going down. So I'm just worried that maybe there is another reason. maybe my videos are not good enough. Maybe I don't put enough effort into them. Maybe I don't edit them very well, which, you know, I'm still learning. So I think that's reasonable, but maybe it's not. Maybe I've changed my style recently without noticing. I don't particularly think I have. Maybe, like, I cut certain things that I didn't used to. I don't know. Maybe I could show more of the gathering of materials, but I find that tedious to do. I don't know about you, so I wouldn't like, as a viewer, I wouldn't like to see it, but maybe that's a thing. So I just want to know, tell me in the comments, is there anything I can do to improve the videos, in your opinion? That's all I want to know. You know, it just makes me sad that the numbers are not growing like they used to. You know what I mean? Like I said, I don't do it for the numbers, but to see it not increasing, not gaining any, it's just, yeah, that's not a nice feeling. Anyway, like I said, if you do have any suggestions, please leave them in the comments for me. And yeah, thank you. Back to the video. All right, guys. So that was a bit of a strange topic to talk about, but something I kind of I've been thinking about recently, so I just wanted to address it. And okay, so as you can see, we have a pretty detailed wall over here, and I'm not honestly loving all of it. This is going to annoy me. Thank you. That'll grow. It'll be fine. It'll look good. The vines in this place actually really add a lot, so I like the idea of spamming them. I don't generally, but I do for this build. Anyway, I don't like the amount of this slime in here. I actually originally started doing a lot more, and then I came back and took out some of it. I think I'm going to take out some more of it, because it's it's probably taken over just a little bit too much. I think I went a little bit overboard with it. But otherwise, I'm quite happy with this. This is a very, what's the word? Where it's like hodgepodge, where they threw together whatever wood they had and made a wall. I like the idea of that. Okay, so, beside me doing a little bit of changes to the wall, what I have to do now is figure out, first of all, where this lake is going, how large it's going to be, and then I probably have to dig out a huge amount of blocks, which is always fun. I love it. I love the digging. All right, guys, so I've just pulled it up here thinking that maybe this is going to be the center of the lake, and actually it's a little bit too close to there and also to there, so I think I'm going to move it to maybe in between those two splotches there. I think that would be a good center point for the lake. It does mean I've got to clear out a lot of water, which is always a bit of a pain, but maybe I could go grab my sponges that we got from the ocean monument. Maybe that would help. Yeah, that's actually not a bad idea. Okay, as you can see over there, it sort of opens up a little bit, and I can tell you that a little further away over there is a witch hut. Ah, so eventually we can actually do a witch farm in this area, and it's actually far enough away that when we do the perimeter around it, you know, you like clear out so many blocks all the way around it, so the mobs, no mobs spawn in that general area to make it, you know, maximum efficiency. I believe we still do that, I think. Yeah, we can do that, and it won't actually encroach on this build. So that should be okay. It is far enough away that we can actually do that. So I like the idea of that. That seems pretty cool to me. As you can see, the corner of the wall that I did, I felt like this was a fair amount of work, but looking at it, that's nothing. That really is nothing. Up here, though, there's going to be a lot of space. I don't know. There's going to be a lot of space. Like, this could be turning into a big project. Why do I do this to myself? Okay. Maybe in that case, we do move the lake this way a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, that might be a good idea. Okay. Yeah, so we can stick to this center point for the lake, and I just got to clear out a load of stuff. Okay. Okay, so I think I may have made a mistake. you can see I've done the outline for the lake. I was using lime clay at first, and it's massive. It's way too big. I'm going to have to changed my mind on this because I don't want to do another huge project. I don't want to do another jungle temple. Okay, I think I'm going to move the lake over there a little bit and do it a little bit smaller, change all the outline, and I guess replace a bunch of blocks that I'd taken out. Okay. Okay. Alright guys, so I've tried a different, more manageable size for the lake now, and I'm pretty happy with this. As you can see, I've done a sort of more natural shape to it as well. I've still followed some of the rules that I use for curves, but I think this looks pretty good. And in the middle, I've done this island, and I've used our sort of design that we're going to use for the ground for this place. You can't really see from up here. It doesn't actually look very good from up here, but down below, you can see I've bone mealed it, and so it's got a load of like grass all over it, and like too tall grass and things like that. It looks really sort of overgrown, and it just looks really cool. Okay, so for the next task, the unenviable task of covering this in sludge, and I think what I'm going to do is obviously going to use the regular sludge design. I'm going to have some glowstone underneath a lot of the sections to light it up a little bit, and I'm still going to keep some of the pools of water, and the sludge is going to be not just flat, it's going to be all like lumpy, I guess. Lumpy is a good word. And yeah, it should be pretty cool, I hope. And for this center part, this column, obviously won't be here, but for the center part, I actually have an idea for what to do in the middle. Now, today has actually been very frustrating. My neighbours are having construction work done, and I haven't been able to record until now, that it is very late. I'm so tired. I actually had a nap, a 20-minute nap earlier on. Yeah, sat down for 20 minutes, have a nap for about 3 hours. Okay, 2 hours, but still. But I'm still tired, and I feel like crap, so this is, Do you know what, maybe something I could do to improve this channel is stop moaning. Yeah, good idea. Alright, so let me get on with the sludge design for the lake. Alright guys, welcome back, and I say welcome back because today is the next day. I actually ran into a whole lot of frustration. The construction thing that was carrying on and just ruining my recording, and then I updated a load of my drivers for my motherboard, which was stupid because it wrecked OBS. and it stopped recording things, which is just great. I need some leaves. Where are the leaves? Give me the leaves. Hello, leaves. I have no... Ah, that'll do. That's fine. Yes, so very frustrating. I don't even know how much I've recorded to show you, but I have made a lot of progress, I imagine. So here it is. Oh, yes. This has been the only satisfying thing about my day, I think. Actually, today has not been too bad. I've been for a family meal, and I've been to watch a movie, which we'll also talk about very soon. That's really annoying. Walking on this stuff is hell. It's fine. And, yes. Look at all this. Like I said, I don't even know what I recorded last time. I have filled the lake with sludge, and then I filled that sludge lake with water, and then I've raised up some of the sludge, and I've added some snot shrooms, and yeah, just these little things in the ground, and little, what do you call them, lily pads, and all the details, little mushrooms, everything that's just disgusting and overgrown in the Minecraft world is here, and I love it. I really do love this. This is looking really cool. It's pretty much exactly what I wanted. Originally, I imagined we would see a lot more of the sludge above the surface, but I toned it down a little bit, and I really like this now, so that's okay. Now, there is some construction going on again today, but they seem to be on a break, so hopefully I can record a little bit of building with you guys. Maybe that would be a great way to improve my videos. Yes. Okay, so what I want to do here is a totem. Yes, I want to build a totem. Now, I'm not going to say that these people necessarily worship slime, but they do kind of revere it as, you know, it's their source of, I don't know, income, I guess, if they sell it. It's diamonds. I mean, not diamonds, emeralds. Yes. So they revere slime. So they want to show their respect for it by building a totem. And I'm going to attempt to do this on camera. Hopefully, I hear some noise. It's fine. Just ignore it. All right, so that's a good shape. And it turns out, no, I couldn't ignore the noises outside. They got too loud, but that's okay. I can't really complain because when I first moved into this house 4 or 5 years ago, me and my dad kind of gutted it and was doing construction work for about 6 months. So I can't complain. It's fine. Okay, guys, so I'm speaking to you now from the video future. Crazy what technology can do these days, right? This totem is basically, it's going to be something that the people in this village, they just threw together with the materials that they had at hand, which is, you know, the normal thing for this village, I think. And it will have a sort of slime, what's the word? An avatar, I guess, at the top, like totems do. It works out pretty well. I actually really like this. Anyway, today I went to see the movie Life, and it has Jake Gyllenhaal and Ryan Reynolds and a bunch of other people who I can't remember the names of, but they're all good actors. And it was well acted, but it wasn't very groundbreaking. You know, it didn't do anything new, and that is my biggest criticism of it. I think, you know, maybe I shouldn't have ever expected it to, but it was essentially a mixture of, like, Gravity and Sunshine and Alien. That's basically it. I won't spoil it or anything like that, but it's maybe worth a watch, but don't expect anything brilliant from it. Don't expect anything new from it. I think that's a real waste, really, considering the talent of the actors that they actually had in the movie. Yeah, it's a shame. It was directed pretty well, and it did have a lot of suspense. The actual alien in it was pretty freaky with what it could do, but also quite unrealistic, a little bit stupid at times. And the CGI wasn't great on it either. It was supposed to be like highly intelligent, which is fair enough, but it did things that it would be impossible for it to know how to do, essentially. Like, I'm not spoiling anything by saying that the communications break down. Okay, so they're in space and the communications go down. And I can't remember if they specifically blamed the creature or just said, you know, there was something that made it happen, that made the communications go down. Either way, that's stupid, because if it is the creature, how did it know how to do it? And if it isn't, it's just a random plot device. You know, oh, the communications have gone down while we have this emergency in space. What a surprise. And it was just things like that. There was quite a few of those type of things in it. I won't spoil anything, but yeah, it put a bit of a downer on it. Like I said, considering the quality of, like, for instance, Ryan Reynolds and Jake Gyllenhaal. I don't even know if I'm saying that right, to be honest. But yeah, considering their quality, I would have expected a little bit more. So quite disappointed, but it was still enjoyable. Put it that way, it's probably worth a watch, I would say. Anyway, back to the video. And I'm just adding the finishing touches here. Let's go take a look. Avoid walking on the slime, because that crap is crap. Okay, it's really awful to walk on, put it that way. And there it is. Wow. Okay, I'm actually really impressed with myself. I've never done one of these before. I actually really like the look of that. I haven't gone for the fully square slime shape, just because I like the idea of having these little notches out of the corners. Makes it look a little bit like a skull. And yeah. There's no real reason for it. I guess slimes can kill you, so there you go. Oh, you would have to be rather stupid for slimes to kill you, but villagers are stupid, so there we go. That makes sense to me. Wow. So this episode has been a little bit all over the place, which is kind of the opposite of what I was going for. I wanted to try and sort of up my game a little bit, and I think in the future I do have some ideas to improve things on the video front. But overall, you know, it's not been too bad. For what I've been able to do while being hampered by noises and things like that, it's been okay. It's been all right. And like I said, with this, I'm really impressed. I'm really impressed with myself. I always am. Let me get rid of you. That had the reeds in, that was all. Just to remind me to put some reeds around the place. Yes. Just in general, I really like the look of this. I think at the back here is where our kind of sludge refinery thing is going to go. So it'll be pumping the slime out of there. I mean, it can come like in, or it can go in any different places, I guess, around the lake. And we'll have lots of this sort of marshland type things around the edges as well. It's not going to be all flat like this. So that'll be nice. And, you know, a lot of the different groundwork blocks that we're going to have. And the place has got to have rivers flowing through it, and then all the buildings off the water, things like that. It's going to be really, really cool, I think. I'm really looking forward to working on it, to be honest. And I do have other ideas for the temple. I did say that maybe we'll be here, or maybe at the temple in this episode, but I decided not to. Maybe next episode we'll go back to the temple. I don't know, because I know that some of you are actually really looking forward to seeing more of that build. But anyway, I'm afraid I have run out of time for today. So, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like. Leave a comment, and if you'd like to see more, click the subscribe button. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.